You've just entered the theater of an alien sky. If the words and images seem strange to you, there's a reason for this. Our world was once a vastly different place. To experience this won't hurt you, and there is nothing to fear. The subject of this video series is the ancient experience of towering celestial forms that are no longer present. Worldwide testimony points to planets extremely close to Earth and gathered in close congregation. We've called this gathering of planets the polar configuration because it was centered at the celestial pole around which the heavens visually turn. The huge sphere of Saturn filled the circumpolar sky. Close to the center of Saturn stood another body, the planet Venus, discharging electrically, the streamers of this discharge stretching upward across the face of Saturn. And seen in front of Venus was a smaller, darker, reddish sphere, the planet Mars. At a critical juncture, a crescent, cast by light from the sun, appeared on Saturn, rotating in an awe-inspiring cycle of day and night. That's because the axis of the Earth was aligned to that of the assembled bodies, causing the configuration to rotate visually above observers in the northern hemisphere, exploding into life at sunset, the beginning of the archaic day of the gods. Yes, the claims are outrageous, but also extraordinarily specific, leaving no doubt as to what the ancient evidence should look like in stark contrast to all common opinion about the ancient past. From a single snapshot of the configuration seen here, we can work backwards to the first appearance of these bodies out of an undifferentiated cloud or sea of dusty plasma. We can follow the configuration's evolution through phases that range from quasi-stability to earth-shaking catastrophe. In these presentations, we'll suggest that all of the mythic and symbolic archetypes can be explained by the presence of these bodies, their electrical exchanges in a plasma medium, and their relative movements in relation to each other. Intense electric discharge formation stretched between the gathered bodies, transitioning from one form to another. First to emerge was the triangular or threefold discharge form of Venus, interpreted mythically as the name of the Creator or three goddesses in one, a widely acknowledged archetype still unexplained. Here, three goddesses reveal the triangular form with their entwined fingers, but the variations on the ancient theme are almost endless, and the initial three-faced form is inseparable from the identity of Venus as the emerging, radiant, great star. The ancient astronomers name the components of this dynamic configuration as planets, different sizes and colors, and changing relationships to each other. The shock comes from seeing the described events in the demanding terms of three-dimensional perspective, where relative movements of the bodies dramatically alter the visual appearance of the configuration. No room for arbitrary explanations. With the later displacement from its polar position, the configuration was seen well into the southern hemisphere. Electric discharge forms metamorphosed violently above human witnesses, providing us with a stunning comparison to plasma instabilities seen in laboratory experiments. Our message comes down to one overriding conclusion. Things anciently remembered bear no similarity to the commonly accepted picture of the ancient sky. In a former time, our world was indeed a much different place.